Alright, first thing first, let's install the package. Open the Unity Package Manager, switch to Unity Registry, and search for navigation. Install AI Navigation, and we are good to go. Now, let's set up the scene. Add the plane, this will be our main surface. Create a material, assign it to the plane, and let's drop in a few obstacles too. Give them materials as well, just to keep everything looking nice. Next, select the plane and add the NavMesh surface component. In the agent type, you'll see some info about the agent, but we'll dig into that later. For now, just know it helps control how our agent behaves. Time to bake the NavMesh. And there it is. The light blue area shows where the agent can walk. But wait, there is a problem. The NavMesh is also showing up on top of the obstacles. And that's not what we want. This could lead to some weird behavior in the game. Here is how to fix it. Select each obstacle and add the NavMesh modifier volume. Set the scale and move the Y position to 0. Then change the area type to not walkable. Bake the NavMesh again and boom, problem solved. Now the agent only works where it is supposed to. Now, we are ready to add an agent to the scene. Let's create a cube and add the NavMesh agent component to it. Here, you will find a bunch of settings to tweak its behavior, like speed, acceleration, and more. But let's get to the fun part, making it move. We'll create a simple click-to-move script. First, we add the layer mask. This will help us detect where we clicked on the map. Then, we add a reference to the agent, and inside the update method, we'll build our movement logic. Here is how it works. When you click the left mouse button, we shoot a ray from the camera toward the scene. We store that ray info and check, using physics recast, if it hit the surface we are interested in. If the ray hits the right spot, we simply call agent.setDestination it.point, and the agent will move to that position. Simple as that. Now, let Unity compile the script. Don't forget to assign the choreogram mask. I also created a new layer called walkable and assign it to the plane. Time to test it out. And it works. The agent moves and reaches the exact point you click on. Pretty cool, right? You could already use this in a game as it is, but what if you want the agent to follow a target instead? Well, let's modify the script a little and add this new behavior. Alright, let's create a simple object in the scene and name it target. Assign it a material so it's clearly visible. Now, let's open the agent script and start by defining an enum. This enum will help us switch between two different movement behaviors, follow target and click and move. Just below the enum, we'll add a public variable to let us choose which behavior we want directly from the inspector. Then, in the update method, we'll check which movement mode is currently selected. If it is click and move, we keep the existing logic. The agent moves where we click. Else, if it is follow target, we'll set the agent's destination to match the target's position on every frame. Back in Unity, select your agent in the scene, choose follow target from the drop-down in the inspector, and hit play. And that's it. So, in just 5 minutes, you now have two functional movement modes with a single script. So, would you say that deserves a like and maybe even a subscribe? What if you have a moving obstacle in your scene? Well, let's see what happens. First, I'll quickly write a little script to move an obstacle. I'll go fast here, no worries. I'll leave the full script in the video description. And you can also grab it, along with the agent script, from my Discord server. and here is what we get. The obstacle leaves a trail behind it on the NavMesh. That's not good. It's like the surface stays marked as occupied, even after the obstacle moves. And even worse, the agent doesn't detect it properly, so it struggles to avoid it. The fix is super easy. Just add a NavMesh obstacle component to the moving object. Make sure to enable curve. This tells Unity to update the NavMesh around the obstacle in real time. You can also set curve only stationary off, or keep curve when stationary and set the delay to 0 for instant updates. Let's try it now, and boom, problem solved. Clean, simple, and it works perfectly. The agent now reacts to the moving obstacle exactly as it should. And hey, if earlier I asked for a like and a subscribe, now why not leave a comment? Help this video reach more awesome game devs like you. Now, let's go back to the agent properties. This time, we want to understand two important settings: step height and max slope. Let's start with the step height. In the scene, create a new cube and place it on top of the plane. We want this to act like a small step, just slightly higher than the ground. Bake the NavMesh surface and try moving the agent over the step. And yeah, it goes up without any problem. Now, let's tweak the step height parameter in the agent settings. Set it to something lower like 0.1, then bake the NavMesh again. What happens now? As you can see, the NavMesh is no longer connected to the top of the cube. This means the agent can't step onto it anymore. Now, let's do something similar for max slope. Add another cube to the scene and rotate it slightly to create an inclined surface, then bake again. Depending on the angle and the max slope value, you'll see the NavMesh either includes or excludes that surface. So basically, step height controls how high the agent can climb, and max slope defines how steep a surface it can walk on. Okay, let's look at another case. What if two walkable surfaces are not directly connected? No worries, the solution is simple and elegant. All we need to do is add an empty game object in the scene and then attach the NavMesh link component to it. Now, just set the start point and end point. This defines where the agent can cross. You can also set the width of the link, which controls the area where the jump is allowed. Hit play and it already works. But there is something missing. The jump looks a bit flat, right? Let's make it better. Unity has a great jump script available on the GitHub repository. Just download it and add it to your agent. Just select the curve option and define the curve profile you want. With this, you get a much more natural and dynamic movement. And here is the best part. You can even use this system to jump between surfaces at different heights. Just adjust the Y values of the start and end point and you are good to go. Let's check out another cool feature of the NavMesh system. We can assign different movement costs to different surfaces using area tags. To show you this, I've set up a simple scene. We got an agent, a NavMesh surface, and a small step on the plane. So far, everything works just like before. But what happens if we assign a different area type to the step and give it a higher cost than the default walkable one? Here is how we can do it. Just use a NavMesh modifier volume and apply it to the object, in this case the step. Then change the area type to a custom one with a higher cost. Now hit bake and check this out. The agent will try to avoid stepping on that area, even though it's still technically walkable. This is super useful when you want to guide your agents along certain paths or make them avoid certain areas, like rough terrain, water, or dangerous zones. And finally, what happens if you have multiple agents in the scene? Well, Unity takes care of that automatically. As you can see, even though they all start from the same point, they are positioned in a way that avoids collisions right from the start. You can control how close they get to each other by adjusting the radius value in the agent settings. it's also a good idea to tweak the stopping distance when working with multiple agents. Setting it a bit higher helps them avoid peeling up at the destination. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. It really helps the channel grow. And hey, all the scripts and files are available on my Discord server, so feel free to join and grab everything you need. Thanks for watching and bye!